You freeze this.
You can't leave both that.
Welcome to a brand new series that I've decided to start on my channel. I want to start painting horror movies that I love. I always thought this would be a really fun idea to get stills from movies and paint them. I've seen a few people do this on YouTube where they find a scene from a movie and paint them. I've done it before. But I thought I would do it in a niche setting, so I would just do my favourite horror films, and one of them is The Shining. I wanted to start off with this one because I think it is really cinematically dramatic and beautiful, and there's a real sense and mood to it, so I thought it would make sense for me to study stuff from a horror film to help develop my horror comic painting skills, maybe? So yeah, that's why I've decided to do this today. And I want to begin with The Shining, and then next week I might do Scream or something like that, or whenever I continue the series, if you guys enjoy this. The Shining is about a guy called Jack who is down on his luck. He is a hardworking man, but he hasn't been able to find a job for a while. He wants to be a writer, that's his dream. So he finally gets his job at a hotel to be a... He becomes the winter caretaker for the Overlook Hotel. Now, his son is kind of actually more of the story's main character, because he has this thing called The Shining where he can hear other people's thoughts. So when he enters the hotel, he also has this unique ability to transfer that to seeing ghosts and things like that. So he sees a lot of horrible things in this hotel, such as ghosts and things coming to life and trying to attack him. I've also read the book, so I'm kind of intermingling that story from the book to the show as well, because I think the book is really, really good as well. If you guys haven't read that, then go ahead and do it. If you like horror books, that is. So Danny's visions become more disturbing, and Jack, you can tell that this hotel is evil and it's affecting him, and from there the story develops. I don't really want to spoil it, but I'm assuming that most people who've clicked on this video have seen The Shining or heard what it's about. Maybe you don't like horror films, so I'm also not gonna be doing anything scary here, so don't worry about that if you're super sensitive to that stuff. But yeah, it's just a film study, basically a cinematography study. I'll be looking at color, composition, and all those beautiful things that go into making a film, because even though it's not the same as doing a comic, I think that you can learn from certain things. Okay, today I'm going to be using my acrylic. Is that how you say it? Acrylic gouache, it's Holbein gouache. I think it's sort of like acrylic gouache. So there's more, like less on the watercolory side, if that makes sense. I've never really used them. I bought them in Japan and then I haven't used them that much. So I'm planning to use them today. Obviously because I've been getting a lot of different paints, like the jelly paints and stuff. I haven't really felt the need to use these, but I think they have a really nice color set, so, and I think they kind of work well within the Shining color script as well, so I want to try and use them. And let's see how we get on. I also have my watercolors because I like mixing watercolors with this. I think they won't mix so well because this is acrylic gouache, but we only find out by experimenting. Recently I have been feeling pretty uninspired. I don't know what it is, but I just find myself struggling to paint or draw. And sometimes this happens. It's not necessarily art block, because I consider art block when you just don't know what to draw. Whereas I know what I want to draw and I know what I want to do and accomplish, but I just feel like right now I'm pretty much just stuck in a rut I finish work and then I'm like, okay, I should do this, and all I want to do is just watch Netflix or YouTube and just relax. And I don't know why I'm finding it hard, because I used to just be able to doodle in my sketchbook or draw or feel inspired to do something. And recently, no, I'm just not feeling that way. So I'm hoping that this new series will help bring some life back to my goals and help me continue on with writing the end of the script of the horror comic, which I've decided on a name. I think it will be called Dark Moon Prom Queen, and I think that's a really fun name, and it really emulates how the story will be and kind of pop-ishness of it, if that's a way that I can describe what it would be like. But yeah, I think it's going to be a lot more fun and story based than my other horror comic. My other horror comic, it was more the first time doing something like that. So I didn't really know what I wanted to do, and I'm really proud of that comic, but I think I want to build upon what my skill set was from that one to this one. And maybe that's something that's holding me back a little bit. Maybe the fear of like not being able to accomplish the same thing again. Maybe that's weighing me down, but I want to do it. I want to bust through this feeling, and maybe it's just like summer grog that everyone gets, you know, when it gets hot. So I just feel like really tired and that, you know, that summer grog. Anyway, I'm digressing. I felt that whilst I was painting these images as well, they have that quirky style of like slightly off perspective and the textures that I like. And I do, at the base of it, kind of like the way that these turned out, but I'm not necessarily super proud of them. I wish that I had more inspiration going into it and felt more like when I first started, I felt really happy to do it and inspired and ready to go, and I wanted to create something that I was really proud of. And then I just kind of went, ugh. And as the day went on, I got a bit more tired. And you know how it is when you're just reaching that point where you're like, this is not getting to what I want it to be. So I have to say that I did kind of give up a little bit on these. They are quote unquote finished, but not to the degree that I wanted to finish them. I think I could have powered through and made them a little bit better, but I think sometimes if you just keep going and forcing yourself, especially when I'm in this mood of like not feeling that inspired, then I think that can be quite detrimental, because next time you do something, you'll kind of remember that like forcing yourself to do something, and it's like the next time you want to get up and try and do that again, I think you can be like, oh, okay, this is what happened last time and it was really horrific, so now I remember that, so now it's even more difficult to do it. I hope that makes sense to anybody out there. Maybe I should have just made myself continue. But yeah, these are the finished images, and I hope this wasn't too negative, but I'm trying to tell you guys that I'm ready to power through. I'm gonna get on with it and finish the horror comic. And yeah, that's basically it. These are the end results, and I'm not particularly proud of them, but I'm not particularly displeased with them either. And I hope that you guys enjoyed watching this video, and I want to continue on this series and maybe do a different movie next time. Let me know in the comments down below what movie you want to see next. And as always, I'd like to thank my patrons for their kind support. They are Lucille, Charlotte and Tim, Jacqueline, Alex, Noxember, Katie, Steph, and Magea. Thank you guys so much for your support. It really means a lot to me. Thanks a lot. Thanks for watching, guys. Please like and subscribe, and I will see you next time. Bye.